Welcome to MVCC Learning Common Statistics Extras. Today I'll be talking about computing probabilities using contingency tables. At the bottom of the screen, I have what's called a contingency table, or what might also be referred to as a two-way table. It has two different types of information and numbers that are cross-referenced between them. This table is based off of a survey in which college students were asked if they listened to music while studying. To begin, before we can start answering questions, we have to first find totals of the rows and the columns. So I'm first going to find totals of the columns. So I'm going to make a note of that at the bottom. And I'm going to first find the total of the listen column. That number will be 268. The total of the do not listen column is 132. Now I'm going to go and find the totals of the rows. So for male, that will be 199, and for female, that will be 201. Now, in order to do anything with the problems, we need to find a complete table total. So if we add either the rows or the columns, I will get my table total, which in this case will be 400. So now, if we want to begin by answering some questions, we're going to take these numbers to find specific probabilities. So for our first question, we're looking for the probability that the student is male. So in order to do this, we're going to look strictly for the male students, which is right across the top, right in here. And we're looking for the total here, so we're looking at the end. So it'll be 199 over everybody in the chart. So it's going to be out of 400. So it'll be the same thing for those that listen. We're again looking for everybody that listens to music, which in this case is the listen column. And we're again looking for the total. So this will be 268 out of 400. And just check with your instructor as to what form they want these answers in, whether they want them in unreduced fractions or as decimals rounded to a specific location. You just want to be aware of that when answering these questions. So if we look at another set, we might have something that's a little more complicated. So question 3 says, find the probability that the student is female and does not listen to music. So if we're looking at an and situation, we're looking for some place where these two intersect in the chart. So we're looking for female and do not listen, which is right here. So where they intersect is going to be 54. So this one will be 54, again out of everybody in the chart, which is 400. For the next one, this one will be male students or they listen to music. That one's different. This is an or here. So when we're looking for ors, and let me clear off the marks in my chart. If we're looking for ors, we're not looking for where they intersect here. We're looking for everybody. So all of the males are here. And all that listen to music are here. So all of the males are 199. All that listen to music is 268. But do you see where they cross? We have 121 that are counted in both the males and those that listen to music. We don't want to count them twice. So in this case, we're going to subtract the 121. So they're not counted twice. So when we add and subtract these numbers, we get 346. And now this number is going to again be out of everybody in the chart, which is out of 400. So now if we look at two more additional questions, these are specific types of questions. So number 5 states the probability that somebody listens to music given that they are female. That's what that line means. So this line here means given. So it's a vertical line. It's not a slash or anything. It's a vertical line. So in this case, when you have a given, that means you're looking out of a specific row or column total. So we always look to the second one. So when we're looking for students that listen, given that they are female, we can mark up just our female row in this case. Now we're only looking for the students that listen out of that row, which is going to be 147. Now, because we are looking for just those that listen out of only the female students, our female total is going to be our denominator this time. So our denominator will now be 201. That's the difference between these questions and the prior questions. Anytime we have a given, we are doing a specific row or column total. Same thing with this last question. We have, in this case, the probability that the student is male given that they listen to music. So again, let me clear out my chart. And then I will remark it. Okay, so now the given is the students that listen to music. So we are going to highlight just the students that listen to music. And now we're only looking for the males in that column. So the males are going to be 121 out of only the students that listen to music, which is 268. So these are the type of problems that are the given problems. So I hope this answers your questions on how to find probabilities from a contingency table, also known as a two-way table. If you have any additional questions, don't be afraid to come see us in the Learning Commons. Thank you.